This is Allen Iverson. You're watching Ball Don't Stop. Yeah.
Baby, you understand me now. If sometimes you see that I'm mad, don't you know no one alive can always be an angel? When everything goes wrong, you see some bad. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
When I give to Girls and Boys Club and AIDS awareness and stuff like that, and I give my money, you don't hear about that.
Right.
You hear about all the negative Allen Iverson stuff, because those ones sell. That's this. It's this world, man. Evil is this world. This is what this world is about. Evil sells.
Right.
You know what I mean? Negativity sells. And that's just what it is when it comes to Allen Iverson. Don't nobody want to hear no nice Allen Iverson story. A bad one, we want to hear the mushy one. We want to hear you can't judge a person by what he look like on the outside. You see it when you see bank robbers. They don't come in there with no sweatsuits on, whatever they have on, suits, man.
Right.
You know what I mean? They come in there looking sharp.
Right.
But they come in there with bad intentions.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So you can't judge nobody by what they got on or how they look and anything like that. Man, you gotta be around the person. That's why the documentary means so much to me, because a lot of people judge me from the idiot box and a pad and a pen. You know what I mean? How do you know that writer just hate Allen Iverson's guts? So it's right. My opportunity to put this out to the world. So I'm gonna put this out there and you know, y'all run with it. And then you had my fans, they sit around, they read stuff, see things on TV, and the ones that's loyal, they get concerned.
Right.
And I've got to the point where I'm 40 years old next month. I'm tired of defending myself. I don't want every rumor that I hear come out and tweet something or, you know, come out with a statement, you know, mm-hmm. trying to defend myself. I mean, it is what it is. I had to grow rhino skin, man. And it used to hurt me when I was younger, when people would say things. Because I don't have a black heart. You know, if you say something that ain't true about me, it's gonna bother. About anything, like, I think I'm the type of person with the biggest heart in the world. You know what I mean? I'll do whatever I have to do for someone that I love and care about. And just thinking I'm some type of rebel. And I think it started with basically the hip-hop look. Mm-hmm. It's just a perception.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? We never seen nobody with tattoos. We never seen nobody with cornrows.
Right.
You know what I mean? We never seen nobody to dress like this. So instead of embracing it, it was like, hold up.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? We'd rather push this away. You know what I mean? But the crazy part about it is they marketed it and used it up.
Right.
Until you got everything out of me. And then now, you know, we take it in.
How much been said, right?
It'll always be that way. You know what I mean? But I'm fine with the fact that it's like that. But long as the people that care about me and that I care about, they understand me. That's the only thing that matters to me. It's an honor to hear that. I changed as far as my growth as a man, but staying true to myself and the people that I love and care about, that'll always remain. It was important because I'm me. You know what I mean? And I gotta look in the mirror every morning. You know what I mean? I want to be able to see myself. I don't want to lie to myself. You know what I mean? And one thing people try to do is try to lie to themselves, try to convince themselves otherwise. But that's not something that I ever did or ever want to do. It's a blessing. You know what I mean? Like, just for one person to say that. You know what I mean? But for a whole culture to say it and feel that way, I can't even really put it into words how that feels.